is Gina.
Hi guys, what's up? Presenting you another deck made by Leo Massey, and today we are trying his Maligos Rogue deck with the lovely Bards up against the Mage. Let's see, we have a Fan of Knives, Preparation and a Zap. That should be a good starting hand. We will keep that one. Blood Mage Salnos alongside, ooh, there it is. Alongside the Fan of Knives would be wonderful, and we are getting it. So if he's dropping a few minions here, we can play the Salnos alongside the Preparation and the Fan of Knives to clear the board. Of course, if the Mage is playing a Tempo Mage, that is, he's playing a Control Mage, you won't see that many minions in his deck. Let's push one damage here. Strategy of the deck is of course to bring the Maligos on the board, and with the extra spell damage you can hit him in the face with quite a few spells, like the Fan of Knives that will deal 8 damage then, or the Witherrange dealing 9 damage.
Here we go.
No, he's not doing anything so far. We have time and wait. There's no need to rush here. You want to have the Maligos on the board and then finish the game.
Someday I'll be just like you.
A Sorcerer's Apprentice and a Frostbolt. Breathing our hero. But we have no problem to kill the Sorcerer Apprentice in general. Quite a few jewels here. Could use the Viscerate, but I want to save that one either for the Flame Waker or to hit him in the face later in the game. So maybe we are just pushing the Apprentice back into the hand. There's the Apprentice again, and he's also playing Khan Intellect, drawing 2 cards. So there's a spell that costs 0 at the moment. Might be a Khan Missiles, could also be a Mirror Image, but it's good to know that he has a spell there that will cost 1 mana in general, and with the Source Apprentice 0. So let's see. Could kill the Apprentice here with the Agent, of course. But we need to play something before that, otherwise the Agent won't deal 2 damage. So we don't have anything right now. And let's play the Drake for another card. Maybe that's helpful, and Eviscerate. And let's play the Preparation and the Fan of Knives. Here's the Sorcerer's Apprentice. We're also drawing another card. There's a Dark Iron Skulker. Would have loved to play that one before the Drake, so we could have just killed the Sorcerer's Apprentice with that one. Babbling Brook gives him another spell. Cult Sorcerer. And there's a Arcane Blast. And there's the Arcane Missiles, dealing 4 damage into the face. We are now dropping the Dark Iron Skulker, killing both minions here. And with the Sinister Strike, the Eviscerate, we already have 11 damage here in the hand. We drop the Salnos, it will be 14 already. So quite decent. Dropping a Drake and another Arcane Blast. Lucky him. Well, well, well. Guess we need to play the Witherate now. Dropping the Thalnos, killing the Drake with the Witherate, and also playing the Edwin as a 6-6. Still not a single backstep so far. 18 cards left in the deck. We have the Auctioneer here, so maybe we can draw some cards. Playing a Cabalus Storm. 2 mana left. He might kill the Thalnos here with the Hero Power. That would be wise. Okay, he's doing that. He also takes 6 damage then into the face. And we have the Emperor, so cheapening our cards. And then we can play the Auctioneer next turn. Down to 20. Fireball on the Emperor, and might be another fireball on the Edwin here as well. He had the spell ready there. Yes, the second fireball. First one was created by the Cabalus Tom, so he's still one fireball in the deck. Now let's drop the Drake first. And the Tom Pillager will give us a coin. Thank you. That is great in combination with the Auctioneer. So we will then draw lots of cards next turn and hopefully getting the Maligos. 14 cards left. He might have a Flamestrike killing both minions. That's a Cult Sorcerer. And only a Water Elemental, no Flamestrike. But Frostmourer is great. Preventing us from hitting the face here. Preparation, dropping the Fan of Knives, drawing 2 cards, there's a Shadow Strike and a Backstab. Both cards I would have loved to get before before playing the Fan of Knives. So I would say we are just hitting the face here with the Visorate. Drawing another card, there's a Zap, so we can push the Water Elemental back into his hand. Another Sinister Strike, let's see, that will be 8 damage, he will be at 6, and we have double the Agent here. So let's try that one. Also a Barnes. Here we go. Could still attack the Faith, and there's the Maligos. So he is down to 5. And most likely we'll win next turn. Double Agent will deal 4 damage, plus the weapon, that will be 5. So he would need the Oxa one, and there it is, of course. Yeah, protect the king. With the Nether, killing the whole board. And secret, secret, secrets. Ah, that's fine. Killing himself, so we win the game. Thanks for that, Yogg.
Valera versus Rexxar.
Our second opponent is using a Hunter. See how that one goes. We have the Auctioneer here, preparation and a Fan of Knives. Can't keep the Auctioneer on the starting hand, unfortunately, but the preparation with the Fan of Knives is pretty good. Maybe getting another spell damage minion like the Thalnos. Shadow Strike and the Backstab, looking fine here. Hunter is starting with the Fury Bat on turn 1. And take that one out easily with the weapon, taking 3 damage.
Such big teeth I have.
And a kindly grandmother.
Here we go.
So we either take another damage and then play the backstab. Or we could just play the backstab and the agent. But normally you want to save the agent here. There's no need to play it. Taking out his minion anyway. Next turn we will play the Barnes. If we are getting the Octane on the board with the preparation and one of the spells, we might get some pretty good cards.
Tonight, a tale of glorious redemption.
Let's see. What do we have here? There's the Maligos. Ooh, that's not bad as well. So preparation, and we are using the Fan of Knives. Unfortunately, we don't have any more huge spells in the hand at the moment, so we can't kill him here easily. We have the Shadow Strike for another minion, but that's it. That's a Cloaked Huntress. Giving him one secret. Might be an explosive trap. So, alright, nothing happens. There's the freezing trap. Using the Shadow Strike here, of course. And let's get the Salnos on the board, because he will give us another card. So if our opponent is dropping a minion here, we can attack with the Salnos to get another card and hopefully a spell. An animal companion. And it is the Huffa. That is quite bad. Now let's drop the Emperor. Kill the Huffa. And that's the agent, so we will take out the Hyena next turn. But prior to that, cheapening our cards. Kill command, taking out the Emperor. And it looks like he's putting a Houndmaster on the Hyena. That will buff him to 5. And that's a zap. Zabby zap, zabby zap. So let's play the Barnes first.
A tale of what
Dark Iron Skulker, that's not very helpful. Just going to the face, bringing us down to 10.
On with the show.
We are killing the infested wolf here. Then play the Drake. Also getting an Eviscerate with the preparation. And the ship. We will do 2 damage on the Houndmaster. Then take it out with the Dark Iron Skulker and dropping both agents. Clear the spiders. Hopefully he's not getting a Call of the Wild now. Deadly shot, taking out one of the agents. And the steady shot, we are down to 8. And that is quite fine. Let's drop the Auctioneer. The Eviscerate will deal 5 damage. We are drawing another card. Sinister Strike, another 4 damage into the face. Dark Iron Skulker. So that brings him down to 8. Three cards left in the hand. He has one Hyena there, so 2 unknown cards. That's a Call of the Wild, but that's not enough to finish us here. And with the Maligos that we just draw, we have the Backstab ready and kill him.
Hey, lights out.
And that's the conclusion of today's episode. Thank you for watching. If you like my content and want to see more of it, check out my other stuff on the channel or simply hit the thumbnails in the end card you are seeing right now. You can always reach out to me in the comments with feedback or deck requests, so don't be shy. Last but not least, if you want to support me, you can do so in various ways. Subscribe to my channel, follow me on Twitter and Twitch, or use my affiliate partners, which can be found in the description box below the video. It will allow me to keep the channel and new content coming in on a regular basis. Until then, see you in my next video and goodbye.